Okay, so this is basically a shitty, poorly researched philosophical take that you'd find in some intro to philosophy class, but can you really be wrong with philosophy? Anyways, time travel kinda sucks. I mean, it's a cool writing concept that expands possibilities in fictional writing, but I'm talking about real life here. So that means I'm not talking about things like Back to the Future or Pokemon Mystery Dungeon, because events in the past haven't affected the future yet. They kind of happen in sequence or in parallel, despite the future taking place after all those events by definition of the future. Like how there's still a primal Dialga for Grovyle to fight in the future, even though you already fought him in the past, and how Marty was disappearing while trying to keep his parents together, even though Marty's existence is conditional based on his parents getting together in the first place. Okay, on a completely unrelated tangent, I don't actually know how the plot of Back to the Future works. I'm just assuming that that's what the Consequences Sketch by Key and Peele was referencing for one of their bits. So I'll be looking at logically consistent time travel. Now, I'm no expert, so I've probably missed something, but I can think of two different forms of consistent time travel. Multiverse time travel, in which time travel means going between different timelines, and time travel as is described by the bootstrap paradox. But first, I need to clear up some of the issues people have with the bootstrap paradox, because some people don't like it or understand it very well. In case you don't know what the bootstrap paradox is, I'll be stealing this example from this video, which I'll explain why later. But imagine you find a book on time travel on your desk. You build a time machine according to its schematics, and it works. Then you go back in time to leave the book for you to find in the past. The first problem people usually have with the bootstrap paradox is that there is no sense of cause and effect, or generation of information. Like, where did the book originate from? But this problem also exists for our universe too. Take the Big Bang, call this time equals zero. We can extend the timeline infinitely outwards with an infinite amount of nothing occurring before the Big Bang, and an infinite amount of nothing occurring after the heat death of the universe or something. I mean, technically other stuff could happen too, but even if nothing else happened, there is at least an infinite amount of nothing we could add. So now if we ask where did the universe originate from, we can't find the start of an infinite line, kind of like how there is no biggest number. And just like how there is no first event that started the universe, there is no first event that starts the time loop, since you can follow the loop infinitely long. It would be like asking where does a Mobius strip or a circle start. There is no distinguishable feature to denote a start in the first place. I'm not saying that the Big Bang wasn't the event that shaped the universe to the way it is today. I'm just saying we can technically say something else could have happened before the Big Bang, even if it was nothing that happened before the Big Bang. Another problem people have with the bootstrap paradox, specifically in the example I provided, is the fact that the book has to be infinitely old, which would defy some laws of entropy. But the problem with this example is that it fundamentally ignores the concept of the bootstrap paradox. If I receive a book that is 0 months old, spend a month building a time machine, and go back to give myself the same book, it's no longer the same book. It's a 1 month old book now. Meaning this cycle of events can't happen in a bootstrap, it's not a loop. I mean, it could technically be infinitely old, but that would be a bigger issue for physics to solve. But under our ideas of free will, we should be able to decide if we want to give ourselves the same book, or rewrite the book, or not even give ourselves the book in the first place. Meaning if bootstrap time travel existed, we fundamentally couldn't have free will. Everything would probably be fundamentally predetermined and our choices wouldn't really matter. I mean, if we did exist in such a universe, then us caring about this wouldn't even matter because we wouldn't even have the choice to change our opinion on the matter. Not that our opinions couldn't change, we just wouldn't have the choice. Illusion of free will or something. Multiverses don't fare much better either. If every decision creates a branch, then both choices effectively happen. For simplicity's sake, let's say you have to decide between picking up an apple and not picking it up. If you pick up the apple in one timeline and don't pick up the apple in the other, then did a choice really occur? Or another way to think about it is how do you choose which timeline to follow? Sure, you must have picked the timeline to follow, but another timeline exists where you picked another outcome. Or in other words, we have an illusion of choice because both of these timelines happened. Also, if somebody can see your future, that is hop onto your time stream later down the line, they'd essentially view your life as if it were a movie. In a movie, the characters look and feel as if they have free will, but you can always skip to the end and the same thing will always happen. Everything must be predetermined if time travel existed because time travelers can hop to any point in time. And so, if future you already exists in a way, and must exist by definition of being the future, then are the actions you're taking in the present really actions you've decided to make? So maybe it's a good thing we don't have time travel, so we don't have to think too hard.